Well, I think it was inspired by the setting. Like the Glenmore Reservoir pathway is one I like to walk or bicycle around several times a year. And it's a circle, so sometimes you go in one direction, sometimes you go in the other direction. And I just had this idea of two youngish characters, maybe people in their 30s, who are hit by just a sudden, such difficulty and brought so low down in their life. And one is walking in one direction and one is walking in the other direction, and they just happen to meet and share a moment. So I think the concepts came from there.
I think the first thing that struck me was it was two stories, two people, two situations, and the story flipped back and forth from one person to the other, and in the end they came together. And that's something that I wanted to portray in my art book as well. So actually I bound it a little bit differently. I bound it on the left and the right, so all the images that have to do with Jeannie's story are on the left, bound on the left side, and all the images that have to do with Paul's story are bound on the right side, and they overlay one another. And the very last image where they come together is bound on both sides, so it's kind of symbolic of how Susan wrote her story. So the objects that bind it together are UV tubing to represent Jeannie, who's a cancer patient, and a sharp pencil, which represents Paul, who's a high school teacher, or junior high school teacher. Well, the technique I used is etching, which the way I etch is typically black and white, and you can do multiple plates and multiple colors, but I found it needed a little bit of something here and there. I added aquatint, I added chinquelé, which is a technique where you add paper. And for that very last image, where they come together, even if it's temporary, it was a very optimistic, hopeful moment for both of them, and it needed to be in color. So I added watercolor to that print. I wanted to include the little snippets of text that inspired that image, and I used them as an overlay, sort of a foreshadow, if you will, and also a way to frame the picture, so in that way the words are part of the art.
Well, I felt more I had written the story and it was essentially published. So at that point you're kind of letting the story go. So I felt I was more letting Sylvia run with it. That was just my approach to it. So she would send me things back for, you know, for comment and for feedback. But I really felt I was giving it to her to do what she wanted as an artist rather than try to control it or get involved with it at that point.
Yeah, thank you for that.
Well, that was just how I preferred to do it. And so at that point, that it was her baby.
For all the pairs that I saw, I think they did an excellent job, and everybody, you know, friendships were grown, and a community of artists, writers, and printmakers was established. And like Susan was saying, this project has grown a life of its own. It just keeps taking another step bigger and bigger. So.